Alright, so now we got our CPU and we're going to be taking that out. Right here in the box, you can see it right there on top. And this, most of the box is actually filled with the standard heatsink. And if you're not going to do any sort of overclocking or whatever, it also comes with a little sticker that you can put on the front to brag. Because everyone likes to brag. And if you're not going to do any overclocking, this actual, the standard one that it comes with is actually just perfect for you. But I'm going to be partaking in a little bit of CPU overclocking, to say the least. And yeah, so that's why we have our own separate heatsink water cooling system. And once we get it out here we go. This is it. This is our main pride and joy. So we're gonna go ahead and install that next. So let's go ahead and take it to a different camera angle for that portion. All right, so now we're gonna be removing this little fastener thing here. So simply all you do is you pull on this metal bar. You're gonna kind of want to push it down and out, and that's gonna come up. You can see this little sort of thing undoes like that. And if you look here on the CPU very closely, I don't know. See if we can get a pretty good. No, that's way out of focus. Well, there is on the corner a triangle. Now you want to line that triangle up here
I
on
can
the.
see it. Sorry for barging in, but I'm obviously manning the camera. So actually just move your hand a little bit, or actually just put it in. You can see just the very tiny little tip of the top. It's actually from this perspective to our right, on the bottom right corner, there's a little triangle on not only the motherboard but the CPU. On the CPU it's gold
Yeah.
plated. And you just have to line those up. And now we have to take off the plate on the back of the warning sign.
This?
Yeah.
No, that's fine. That can stay on there.
No, because obviously we have to take that off so that the thermal
Oh,
paste
yes. That is correct.
on the thing comes on. So let's go ahead and remove that.
Yeah, we'll see if we can do this. I've never had to do this since most of my builds have all been AMD
Yeah.
processors. With AMD, just kind
Yeah,
of.
AMD is cheaper and just simple. They're different, two different, completely different builds for putting on
There we go.
the heat sinks. So he might not be too. All right, so now we're just gonna go ahead and
Yeah.
push it down, and it might be a bit scary to put it in because it feels like you're gonna break the damn CPU.
That is for sure. It sure does. Let me just make sure it is in
It
there.
is. You're just gonna have to bite your teeth and hope you don't actually break your CPU.
It's.
All right, so now looks like we're done with the CPU and stuff. We're gonna go ahead and I suppose we're gonna go ahead and mount the.
The front bracket. So, yeah,
Yeah.
well, we did a video actually previously. If you've been following the series by going by part to part, if you watch the water cooling system portion of it, we actually put the front bracket on before inserting a CPU. That's this little bit right here, and
We're gonna have to reinstall that because we
yeah.
kind of forgot to install the CPU. People make mistakes, so
Yep.
let's go ahead and install that. I'm gonna cut the video here because there's nothing much to see besides some screwing on of things. See you guys in the next part.